Tuesday was cold, I almost froze my toes. Oh, what's it gonna be next week? Who knows? That's climate. Oh, that's the climate you got. You take a bunch of weather and you average it together and you're doing the climate rock.
Glacial pace. It means something's happening so slowly you can barely tell it's happening at all. That used to describe the very incremental movement glaciers and ice sheets experienced each year. But now that's changing. We're tagging along with three NASA scientists to understand the different lengths they go to not only investigate ice sheets and glaciers, but also communicate their often complicated science to the public. First, let's get oriented. Ice sheets, in pink, pretty much occur in only two places, Antarctica and Greenland. Glaciers, in yellow, play a key role draining melt off the ice sheet. Glaciers are also found in the high mountains, but we'll get to those in another episode.
So we know that something's happening in Greenland right now that's unprecedented in the last several thousand years.
That's Dr. Josh Willis, oceanographer at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory. Josh and his team are tackling one of the major environmental challenges of the 21st century, trying to answer fundamental questions about how melting glaciers impacts sea level rise.
With my mission, Oceans Melting Greenland, or OMG for short, we're trying to understand just how much of Greenland's melt is caused by the oceans.
Along with being one of NASA's top scientists working on the cryosphere, Josh is passionate about demystifying climate change in typically unconventional ways.
I think by reaching out to people with a little bit of humor, a little bit of fun, maybe a song, you really have the opportunity to help people understand and come to terms with what we're doing to our planet. Because it's definitely happening and it's definitely a big deal, and we need to start preparing for it.
Down at the opposite pole, Dr. Kelly Brunt is getting ready for a major expedition.
In December and January, this coming year, I'll actually be in Antarctica, down near the South Pole, collecting ground-based GPS data.
This is actually Kelly's second expedition to the South Pole. The first occurred in December and January of last year. Both surveys are critical and will help validate data collected by NASA's airborne campaign, Operation IceBridge, and the recently launched satellite mission ISAT-2.
All three of these layers, that ground base, that airborne, and the satellite, are all tied together. The ground base helps validate both the satellite and the airborne helps give us more validation data for the satellites, but also a bigger story with respect to the depth of the ice sheet and what's going on underneath the surface.
While some scientists are taking measurements in the field, others are looking for answers in physics and lines of code.
For me, though, those projections that we are doing, they do have a very personal meaning.
Dr. Sophie Nowicki is an ice sheet modeler. That means she and her team have the important job of forecasting how ice will change in the future, which also predicts changes in sea level rise. It's a job she doesn't take lightly, especially since urban planning and infrastructure use her team's models to make decisions about the future and safety of their communities.
When we make those projections that are 100 years in the future, 100 years can seem so far away, like I don't have to worry about it, it's just too far. But actually they're not. It's really like the future that we're looking at that our children or grandchildren will see to experience.
Whether it's learning to communicate in new ways, traversing a swath of Antarctica in a massive piston bully, or taking responsibility for an impactful climate forecast, our NASA explorers are pushing the limits of discovery every day. But on a very human level, they're people with families and friends who have a stake in finding out why and how the planet is changing as rapidly as it is.
Every place, at least so far, that we have found life, we found water along with it. And so when we try to understand the thresholds for life, where life might exist elsewhere in our solar system and the universe, water is one of those things that we look for.